Good morning, afternoon, evening, whatever time it is right now. This is about my third attempt to do this video, so I'm hoping this one is going to go smoothly. So we're on week three, Era Study 3, film music. We've been going through slowly Mad T-shirts, all the elements of music that help to describe music in film, which obviously adds to the action and what's going on. What I would really, really like you to do, first of all, is I want you to watch a clip for me. Now, it's this clip on the screen here, which obviously you can't click on the screen. If you scroll down, you will find in the comments, I believe, the link. So if you can pause the video now and just watch that clip. Pause now. Okay, right. Hopefully you've watched that. Just a really good example of how, just by altering instruments, tempo, dynamics, you can alter the whole feel of a scene. I thought that was really interesting. Right, let's carry on. So we are looking at dynamics and tempo, she says. Here we go. So key facts this week. It's pretty much just vocabulary. So dynamics, how loud or quiet something is. Crescendo, to get louder. So if the music gets louder, uses a crescendo. Also looks like a hairpin, a bit like this but bigger. Yes, it's like a maths bigger than sign. Diminuendo, to get quieter. That's the opposite. It's like a maths get smaller than, if you imagine a hairpin that way. Accent, a sudden loud note. Okay, so a sudden heavy downward beat. They are the symbols here and here for accents. Piano is quiet, forte is loud. Hopefully these will not be a surprise to you. Tempo, so move on to tempo, the speed of the piece of music. And then I've picked out just a fast, a medium, and a slow vocab for you. There are many more, and you'll see on the next slide. But these are at least three that I want you to get to grips with and own. So allegro, fast. Moderato, hopefully that should be easy, as medium. Adagio, slow. Accelerando, to get quicker. And ritardando, to slow down. Really important, those ones in film music. Really important, because they can have a real strong impact on the music and on the feel of the music and the mood. So these are, I'm really sorry, it's just a massive long list of words, but it's really important you know them. What I've tried to do is group them so the dynamics go from the quietest up to middle quiet, medium loud, loud, very loud, and then you've got crescendo, diminuendo, sforzando. Okay, tempo, I've gone from very slow to very fast. I've tried to pick ones that you might remember, like Hey Presto. I don't know, it might look familiar. Allegretto, you should already know because it's the speed of the minuet and trio. Accelerando, ritardando, or rallentando, both mean to slow down. And rubato, to slow up and speed down. Oh, slow down and speed up. So you need to know that one as well. Okay, so they're ones for cue cards, really. Just, you don't necessarily need to use every single one of those words. You may well need to have a word to suggest fast or slow, but if you can recognise what they mean, so if you can translate them into your normal language, you don't necessarily need to use those words. Okay, right, so we're going to look at tempo first. We're going to break it down into each of the words. So we're going to start with tempo. I've picked two pieces. Adagio for strings. Adagio we've just looked at, if you remember what that word meant. So adagio for strings, it's from the film Platoon, and it is a war film. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is have a listen to this one, and all I want you to do is comment on the tempo and see if you can relate it to the genre of war. So pick out some descriptive words or some scenes in your head that it kind of, some imagery that you can relate it to. So say what you hear to do with tempo, and then try and get it to make sense in a sentence of something that you could, it could be reflecting. Okay, very similar to how we did it last week. Okay, so here is Adagio for Strings by Samuel Barber. Okay, if you need to listen to that again, then feel free. It's quite a small, it's quite a short clip, but I don't think you need a lot more to say. There's not about 10, there's not like 10 comments to be made about this. Just a couple of really good ones would be great. So feel free to stop, take it back and replay. Okay, right, we're going to move on to Vangelis. This is the end theme, so the final credits of Blade Runner. It is action sci-fi, okay? So think about the title, Blade Runner, action sci-fi. All I want you to do is comment on the tempo, okay? Comment on the tempo and see if you can relate it to sci-fi or action, okay? Here we go. Again, if you need to take that back, take it back, have another listen, get as much detail as you can. There's more to be said about this one, I think, but we'll see. Right, take it back and listen. Okay, so let's go through some of the answers that I came up with. This is not exhaustive by any means. You might come up with totally different stuff. There is some basic right and wrong, but in terms of relating it to a theme or to a story, you can be as creative as you want with it, really. Okay, so Adagio for Strings first. Let's have a look. Okay, so the basic is there is a slow tempo. It's called Adagio for Strings. Adagio is slow. So it's a slow piece of music. And I've put, it could relate to the sadness of death. So the sadness could be someone's last dying thoughts. Or I've put, it could be slow motion of a final battle scene. Again, lots of death, people dying, but it could be sort of a slow motion, but you'd have to get the slow motion of it. You couldn't just say the action of war because the piece is slow. So need to be, you need to relate it a bit more carefully than that. The Vangelis. Oh, sorry. Adagio for strings as well. Use of rubato. Rubato, we use that word to slow and slow down and speed up. Okay. Vangelis. So medium tempo. It was a medium tempo, but it had this constant semi-quaver pattern in the accompaniment, which gives the impression of speed. And it was constant. Okay, so the tempo didn't waver, didn't get faster, it didn't slow down. Steady pulse, that's what I've just said, didn't slow down, didn't speed up. It's just steady. Okay, right. Dynamics is the next one. So I'm going to play you Hoist the Colours, which is Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End. See what you think. We're now talking about dynamics, so we're talking about volume. Here we go.
The king and his men stole the queen from her bed and bound her in her bones. The seas be ours in both.
Okay, listen again if you need to. Otherwise, we're going to move on to Planet of the Apes. So, this is The Hunt. So, again, we're going to watch it, listen, sorry, we're going to listen to it. If you can, while you're listening to it, be writing down ideas of how the dynamics relate to The Hunt, or generally how the music relates, but describe to me what happens with the dynamics. Okay, here we go. Again, go back if you want to on that, but I'm going to carry on because I've only got 2 minutes left. Right. So, the dynamics of Pirates of the Caribbean, it was very quiet. Drum roll, crescendo, and then it went back to silent again. It got pauses to build tension. So that was silence. And then solo boy's voice, monophonic. I know we're not talking about texture, but it was just worth putting in there. And that was quite quiet as well. Planet of the Apes. It was mainly medium loud most of the time. There was a piano ostinato on the piano, quiet as if footsteps were in dun 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 dun. But they were quietly in the background. Lots of accents, as if someone's jumping out or jumping in and out of trees, or they're pouncing on someone, and crescendos building tension, and diminuendos letting the music ebb away again. Okay, I'll let you go back over that when you've got a bit more time. Right, dynamics and tempo, I'm not going to go through those again, I've already done it, but they are your keywords for this week. Before next week, make sure your notes are looking good. Use music first to go thoroughly over tempo and dynamics. Can you do the level 2 test, please? On dynamics and tempo, you'll need to go to the tests tab. In fact, I'll take you there. Test tab here, test index, and then on the left, I'm probably going to get kicked out. On the left, it says there's a search. Okay, so search here, dynamics. Okay, and then level 1, 2, please. All right, and you can do the same on the other one. All right, so I will see you next week. Please get onto Teams if you haven't already, and I will see you next week. Take care. Bye.